Hello guys, welcome to SWK Tutorials. Today I will be teaching you how to do Vray Fur in 3ds Max. Vray Fur is a very simple tool for creating procedural furs. The fur is generated only during render time and can be used to create a wide variety of render time effects such as fur, hair, grass, and rug, which we are going to do in this video. Select the mesh and apply the material. Render it. Save the render and apply Vray Fur using Vray Fur icon. If we look at our scene, we can see these guides that give us the sense of how the fur effect is taking place. Now render the scene again. What we get in the image isn't exactly the picture that our guide is giving us in the viewport. This is because the preview in viewport max hairs are set to 1000, which are very less as compared to our per area distribution. If you want to see more in the viewport, then simply increase your max hairs, but I will not recommend you guys to increase it more than this. Plus, one more thing, it is giving us the green color. It is actually coming from here. So, to change this, apply your material on the Vray Fur and render again. Now, let's start changing the Vray Fur parameters. The first parameter that I'm going to change is my length. I don't want to be that much high or long in length. So I'm going to decrease my length to 8 and render again. But before rendering, I'm going to save it. Don't worry, I know these strands are still long, but to teach you guys these other parameters, I will keep them long for some time and then in the end we will short their length again. Compare the results. You can see 15, 8. The next parameter that I want to change is my fur thickness. I don't like it to be that much thick. So I'm going to decrease my thickness from 0.2 to 0.1 and render. Save the render and compare. You can see that my fur strands are thin. Now I will discuss knots. Higher values make the strands smoother, these fur strands smoother, but also add to the render time. High values are usually needed when the strands are curved. If we decrease them, you can see they are like this. But don't increase them too much. I will increase them from 8 to 16. Next, I will discuss gravity and taper, the two confusing parameters. Using gravity, you can control the force that pulls the fur strands up and down along the direction. You can see down and up. Using bend, you can control the elasticity of the fur strands. If you set the bend to 0, all the strands will be hard and straight. Change your gravity to minus 1 and your bend to 0.3 and render. Save the render and compare. You can see previously they were very rough, but since I have decreased the values, now they are not that much rough. Next, taper. Taper allows you to add taper to individual fur strands. Increasing this value makes the tip thinner and roots wider. Enter 1 and render. You can see the result. Taper 0, taper 1. If you are making grass, then I will recommend you guys to increase the taper to 1 or something like that. But for this rug, I'm just going to keep it to 0.2. Fur area controls the total number of fur strands. Decrease it from 0.2 to 0.001 and render. And compare. You can see 0.02, 0.001. Now, increase them to 0.1 for this example. If you look carefully, there is some randomness or variations in these trends. This is because of these variation parameters. Currently, all of them are set to 0.2. So, they are adding a variation of 0.2 in direction, length, thickness, gravity, and curve. Increase the length variation from 0.2 to 0.3 to add a little bit more variation in the length. This will add beauty to the rug. Now, I will decrease the overall length to 1 and render. Save the render and compare it with our initial result. You can see the result. If you apply the texture, this will be your result, but if you just apply a Vray fur, your result is going to increase a lot. You can also add some more variations and play with it to make it according to your like. Let's see another example where I will use the length map to control the length. Select the mesh, click Vray fur icon. Since I am working on the same scene, Vray fur has all the old values that I used in the previous fur. If you want the default values, then reset 3ds Max and open the scene again. Apply the texture and render. Save the render. Now, I will put this black and white image in my length map. Open your material editor. And make it an instance. Now render. Save the result and compare. If you look closely, you can't see these gray lines. Reason: these gray lines are defined as black in your length map parameter, so they have no height. Actually, black means no height. So that's why these gray lines are not visible in this render. While this and this part is visible because it is defined as white over here. So this is how you can control your fur using your length map and other maps. You can also use a grayscale image. It's not necessary that you use black and white image. And that's all for this tutorial. If you like it, give it a like. If you love it, then don't forget to subscribe and share the video. Bye guys, keep creating.